just sweet potato. When sweet potato is life. When you got to get some carbs in before you train, but you don't have time, so you just end up eating a whole packet of sweet potato.
I'm very good, thank you.
Good.
Just in case you don't know, you got to wear the... Where is it? Go. And then you got the stealthy ones because people go, oh, what are they? And they go, oh, you know, they're Rick Browning, you know, CrossFit.
So CrossFit.
This is new team. Look at this. There's like little bar holders. And we got new boxes team, look. Whoa.
The boxes are real cool.
Ooh. And team, look at this. We also have some new bikes.
We have a,
ooh. This box is turning into more of a box day by day.
Hey, look at this, Kieran. It's Christmas again.
Christmas every day, favour. It's the last ones now, though. It's getting sad. I like having a box every day. Something to build.
As Christoph Holvas would say, it's very wet and it's very windy
today.
Wet and windy day. Oh, that's the keys in the English. A lot of the time I don't see the point in how your physique looks in CrossFit, but a lot of people I know, and you know, it's like the fitness industry in general, you're like, I want to look good, because a lot of the time that's why we do exercise, as well as being fit and feeling healthy and being able to do all the cool stuff like freaking rope climbs, snatches, handstand walks, all that malarkey. You also want to look pretty good. My ears are popping after that workout. That was 270 calories in just under 12 minutes. Sprints. Oh. Anyway, I've been doing CrossFit now for 3.5 years. Is it 3.5 years? Came from bodybuilding before. Anyway, we're going on holiday tomorrow, and I shaved my chest, and I thought, well, if I'm gonna do a physique update, I might as well do it now. Show you guys what I look like after 4 years of CrossFit and doing adult PE and fitness. Let me just explain. Over this last 3.5 years, I haven't tracked a single macro. I haven't really cared about what I ate. As long as I eat like 90% clean, that's all I really care about. That's like my diet. Like, a lot of people are like, what's your day in the diet? And to be honest, it fluctuates every single day. It depends on when we're traveling, if we're at home, if I can be bothered, you know, all those kind of things. But as long as I'm picking like chicken, rice, lean meats, good carbohydrates, trying to limit my sugar intake every single day. That's kind of how I do it. As long as I'm feeling full, eat a lot of food an hour and a half to 2 hours before training, eat a lot of food straight after training, and the rest of the time I just eat when I'm hungry, and I try and maintain myself feeling full and not feeling like empty. That makes sense. Simple. Just eat when I'm hungry, eat till I'm full, eat till I feel good. Anyway, that is my diet. I just eat, right? Like, it's that simple. There's no macro tracking, there's no carb cycling, there's no intermittent fasting, there's no nothing. I just eat to perform, and then perform when I eat. But one thing I have been doing recently is in the morning not eating like too many carbohydrates, so I don't feel sluggish while I'm training. Just eat a hell of a lot of eggs. I'll eat some fruits. Different kind of carbohydrates has a lot more fiber, has to break down, it's more slower releasing. No kind of like refined sugar. I used to eat massive bowls of oats. I don't do that anymore in the mornings. I do that after a training and before I go to bed. Anyway, this is what I look like, right? Gotta remember my old bodybuilding days too. Ready? Side turn. You're cramped doing that now, he knows. How do you do this anymore? The legs after.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what I looked like when we went to Cyprus.
Three years ago. Do you lose your gains?
You were way better looking.
I think you were probably half the size then.
I think you've thickened up.
Basically, what I'm trying to prove to him is that over 4 years of not caring how my physique looked and only caring now of performance and going in there and killing it and trying to lift heavier every day and get fitter every day and just eating to be a better athlete, my physique has grown with being an athlete. Like, yeah, I'm never going to be like a bodybuilder and be mass overload, like my body.
You eat a lot more nowadays.
Yeah, I do eat a lot more than I did then. I eat a lot more than when I was bodybuilding. But like my body has reached like a, not a physical limit, I wouldn't say physical limit, but where it's comfortable. So I'm like an 88 to 90 kilos, depending on when we go on holiday or not, athlete. And I kind of, my body instinctively eats to maintain that weight. And I train instinctively to maintain that weight. If I feel good doing gymnastics at this weight, I feel good weightlifting at this weight, and I feel doing like the cardio stuff and the sprint stuff at this weight good for me. So CrossFit's one of those like sports where your physique will come with it. Like, I feel like if you're doing CrossFit and you're pushing yourself every day and the numbers are getting better, your athleticism's getting better, you're getting stronger, you're getting fitter, your body's gonna change and it's gonna shape into an athletic build. It may take 2, 3, 4, 5 years. Yes, I've had a background in bodybuilding, so I've kind of got the luck of having a good diet before, building a good foundation of muscle mass before. But if you're always looking to progress and overload your body, it's gonna maintain and grow. And I feel like I've grown over the last couple of years. I don't feel like I've stayed the same. I've got more powerful, my lifting's stronger, my cardio is 100% better, I feel fitter, I feel like more of an athlete.
I think definitely the CrossFit.
He knows. Look, this.
I was just going to say, I think it's important to mention that everybody's different in
following
one strict program that works for you. Like, we do everything pretty much the same. We eat near enough the same. I don't look like you. Like, everybody's.
Yeah, no one's going to look.
You've got a very good metabolism and you've naturally been quite lean anyway. So if somebody's trying to lose weight, they should probably count their macros a bit more. It depends on the end goal, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, I think CrossFit, you definitely. The ability to eat for performance, and because your lifts go up, I know that I've had a bit of an eating disorder, a background of like really punishing myself if I had bad food and doing kind of traditional bodybuilding workouts. I always kind of felt either I restricted or I massively binged. With this, I can get a good mix of actually eating for performance, but with doing the metabolic conditioning and doing the different kind of like monostructural stuff in it, you get the best of both worlds.
But yeah, team, look, this is what I look like now. This is me, this is like nothing. I honestly think like, yes, I've got thicker and probably, I'm just an all round, I feel like more of an athlete now and I feel good.
Feel
4 years
healthy.
Down the line. Like, I think what it was at the start, CrossFit, everyone was like, you're gonna lose your gains doing CrossFit, bad form, because it was bad form. If you look back at like the 2009 games, some of the people doing clean and jerks and snatches and things, they were terrible. But now all of these athletes have got professional weightlifting coaches, professional like cardio coaches, professional gymnastics coaches, people are, if you want to go to the games and you want to go to a high level sanctioned event, you have to be an incredible all round athlete, and bad form doesn't cut it anymore. Like, eating bad doesn't cut it anymore. And like, just kind of winging it, I don't think it cuts it anymore. So if you want to, like, CrossFit is like performance and fun and great fun. And hey, I don't know what I'm saying.
No, you're just rumbling.
Okay, but cool. Team, with this video, I'm not trying to tell you to like go out there and just eat what you want, do what you want, and just train and do CrossFit and you'll like build a physique. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, like, for me personally, like, it just, what I'm saying is it depends on your goals. Like, if you want to lose weight, of course you're gonna have to watch what you're eating, probably eat a little bit less, train still to for goals, still train to get and be a better athlete, but watch what you're eating. But I've just found over the last, especially 2 years of doing CrossFit, like, performance is my number one. The games for me isn't like a goal, so I don't have to be as on point with my diet as I like. With all the traveling that we're doing, if I was trying to maintain, is that a spider on my face? If I'm trying to maintain a diet all year round and like do calories and count it and put stuff on scales, it just wouldn't be viable. I've just been able to maintain and be this body shape and size and put on a little bit of size, but also get fitter and stronger by just eating good, not great, training hard. Anyway, yay.